Okay, let's look at some sketching. So sketching is one of the most important ways to make geometry in NX. It's kind of the general purpose way. Okay, we go to Insert, Sketch in Task Environment. That's how we're going to do our sketches exclusively. He comes up and wants to know what plane to set the sketch down on. Sketches are always two-dimensional. They're different from curves in that respect. So we're just going to take the XY plane, and we will sketch on that. And let's do a less than elegant block. So instead of inserting a block, we'll do a profile of a block, which is basically a rectangle, and then extrude that into a block shape. So I'm going to come out here. I see students do this all the time. They try to get right to 4 inches or something like that, and then we have to continue from here, and they try to get right at something like 1 inch, whatever it is that they're shooting for. Okay, that's a complete waste of time. Okay, notice that these dimensions are they're maroon. Okay, and let's see. Let's go this way. We'll type in 4, and click there, and we'll go here and here. All right, this 4 is really and truly 4 inches. This 1 inch right here. This is only 1 inch until somebody bumps into it. Okay, so if I see red on the drawing, is you know these are going to be red marks. Okay, so if we really want this to be 1 inch, let's double click that, and we'll edit it to be 1 inch. We have to actually type in. If we type it in, he knows that we mean it. Now, if we don't, then he doesn't really know. Now, I just picked a point out in space. To put this rectangle down. It would have been much better, well, for one, to use the rectangle tool, and for another, it would have been better to start and actually position it here at the origin. But that's no problem, really. We can just dimension this to go to the origin. Okay, and I used to always recommend, it used to be that you had to position sketches, and so it used to be the habit that I was in to always start off of the origin and then position in later on. Alright, so there's actually two different things constraining this sketch. We've talked about the dimensions and we've talked about the position, but there's also, these are dimensional constraints, there's also these geometric constraints. And you can kind of see a little blue marker in there. That's a horizontal constraint. I'm going to turn that off. Okay, you see all the little blue marks disappear when you turn this back on. And you can see the geometric constraints. This is a vertical, this is a horizontal. These little blue knobs at the end here mean that those endpoints are connected. Okay, very important that you understand about these geometric constraints, and we'll see more of those as we go along here. Another thing to learn right off the bat is that you can over-constrain a drawing. Okay, he's trying to give me some warning there. Okay, what this means is Your sketch is absolutely worthless. This drawing is junk, okay? Now, it will let you go out and finish the sketch and extrude this, but it's totally garbage, all right? Either you want this or you want the other, so you can't have both of those dimensions on there, all right? You can't over-constrain. It stops working if you over-constrain the sketch, okay? So here's our 4x1 block. I like to name the block, name the sketches. The name is not case sensitive. It always puts it in uppercase. It just makes it easier to come back and when you have a big drawing and find the sketch that you're looking for. So when we're done with this, we finish sketch. And we can extrude this. Usually the default is for feature curves. It may be that you have been set that your filter here has been changed to single curve or something else, in which case he'll only extrude one of the curves at a time. Let me fix this. I want my start and end points to look a little better. There we go. Make a 2-inch block. Okay. So as we select the pieces of that sketch, they can form. I'm going to shift select to unselect those, and let's do it as a feature set of feature curves. So feature curves, now when we select, he sees that okay. And I'll say okay. So this is a way to get a block. This is kind of the more general purpose solution. You can get all kinds of shapes like this. That'll be fun. And they're just as good as blocks, all right? A lot of software now, this is the way to do everything. Like SolidWorks, you start with a boundary like that, and Inventor works the same way. So let's delete this off of here. Yeah, I'll just delete this sketch too. Let's make another one. Insert a sketch in the task environment. This time just for yucks, let's go to a different plane. And let's do a circle. Let's make a cylinder. And this is probably the better way to do a cylinder would be to actually position at the origin there. Now you see that little purple thing light up, and he gives you a little indication that he's actually snapping to a point. That's because these snaps are turned on. If I turn these off and now try to make the circle, you see it looks like it's coming from the origin, but it's not. Very important that you mind these and that your snaps are used properly. Okay. One of them that I would like to warn you about is point on a curve. I like to keep point on a curve unselected until I really need that one. That one can get you into trouble. Alright, so I'm snapping to the origin. And since I've snapped to the actual origin, he won't put a dimension on there to dimension it to the origin. So he's already snapped there. That's all taken care of. It's not fully constrained unless I have entered and got all blue dimensions. You see down here it says sketch is fully constrained. I'm going to undo that for just a second and show you what. Well, not that far. I guess I could redo, but all right. So let's put a circle in here. And he says sketch is fully constrained with one auto dimension. Well, that's not fully constrained, okay? An auto dimension does not truly constrain a sketch. That will be points off. Now, when it says sketch is fully constrained, that's what you want. And let's see, I'll just name this. And it's not case sensitive, but I tend to do that. All right, so there's our cylinder profile. And again, to make a cylinder, we would just extrude this out. So like you see, it's just a general purpose way of making shapes, okay? Let me do, we could do this same sketch here. Let me go ahead and edit this sketch. Let's make an O-ring, okay? So this is our sketch, and I want to edit it. If I just double click it, it takes me to this kind of lightweight editing mode, and that's not what I want. When I edit these, I want to right click and say edit with rollback. This puts me back the way things were when I was actually in here editing this sketch. So let me just put some geometry out here. Okay, I'm going to put a line out here. And let's say that this is going to be my O-ring. This is one way to do this, okay? This is going to be the diameter of the actual ring itself. So I want to actually give this some size. This is a big old O-ring, okay? And this dimension right here is pretty much meaningless, and that one as well. So I'm just, those, yeah, okay, I could, since it says there are auto dimensions down here, I don't like that, okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and give these some actual links so that I can say that it's fully constrained and my professor will not count off for that. All right, so if I'm going to make an O-ring, I do want this to be geometry, but this is just the central axis of the O-ring, okay? And like all things in NX, there are a lot of different ways of doing things. This is just one. But I don't want to actually use this. I want this to be here, this central axis. I want it to be there, but I don't want it to actually become extruded or revolved. And so I'm going to use this little feature here, the convert to or from reference. I'm going to say this is just reference, okay? Now I can finish this sketch. It's fully constrained. And I can do something, this is a little bit fun, so I'm going to revolve this sketch. And he wants to know the axis to revolve around. Well, I just happen to have some geometry that's handy for that. And I'll use, that's that little line that I put in there. That's now the central axis of that O-ring, okay? And so that's one way that I could make a torus shape or an O-ring using a sketch. And kind of an introduction to some reference geometry. We'll see some more uses for that. Well, let me just real quick, I'll just show you one. Let's get rid of this. And we'll put in another sketch in the task environment. And we'll just take the XY plane. So what if we had a triangle and we wanted a circle of a certain diameter to always fit inside that triangle? Okay, let's say we had a, maybe the diameter of this circle is going to change, but no matter what, how the circle changes, we want the triangle to always be around it or circumscribed around the outside of this circle. Or we want the circle inscribed inside it, I guess would be a better way to say that. Okay, so we want a line. It's going to be the bottom of the triangle. I'll just put it in here. But we want this to actually be tangent. Okay, so we want to add a constraint. So I'm going to come in here to my constraints, geometric constraints. And I want to say, look, I need something tangent. And I say, I want, let's go this tangent to that. Okay, and he applied that tangent constraint to it. Now, put another line in here. I want it to start at that endpoint, and he automatically constrained to it because I have these auto constraints. He's going to infer. So I want that to be tangent to that surface of the circle. Okay, so these are both tangent. And now we also want a third line in here. We want it to be tangent to this and joined to the end of that. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and I'll just make it tangent first. And then I can always add, do like a closed corner, or I can go in here to my constraints and I can say, look, I need you two to be joined. So I'll say coincident, this endpoint, and this endpoint. And you see it joins them together there. Okay. So it looks like we're getting pretty close, but this is not exactly what I want yet. So I need to, I want this to be an equilateral triangle, which means that this, I need to make 60. Okay. And I can go around and label this other one as 60, or I can actually constrain it geometrically. Like I can make all of the lines equal length. Let's see if you can do that. Oh, shoot. Yeah, that changed the way this thing works. I can do that. You and you. And this is probably going to blow it up. You and you, all right, and we're fully constrained, okay? So this has to always be an equilateral triangle, and it's always going to be, have this circle inscribed inside of it, okay? But what I want is the triangle. I don't want the circle. I want to be able to change this, 3.5, say, and I want the triangle to be able to change size based on the diameter of the circle, but I don't want the circle to be part of my extrusion. Okay, and here again we'll use convert to a firm reference. This is kind of the classic example of using it. So now it is reference geometry. When I finish my sketch and I do an extrusion or anything from this, you see it only extrudes out the geometry that's true geometry, not the reference geometry. All right, so that's kind of an introduction to sketching.